Hi folks, and welcome to the review of Lenovo X1 Nano, the lightest ThinkPad Lenovo has ever made. What are the main differences between X1 Carbon 9th generation and Nano? And is Nano actually better than M1 Mac? Let's find out! ThinkPad X1 Nano isn't only the lightest ThinkPad ever, but it is also the first one which returns to 16:10 aspect ratio, which is slowly but surely being embraced by many brands in 2021. This one is not the one of those chunky and mighty powerful ThinkPads, but rather ultra portable business machine for people who work on the go or just aren't glued to their desks while working from home. That doesn't mean the performance has been sacrificed. This laptop is an Intel Evo certified, which means that it met strict requirements set by Intel in order to gain the certification. These include things like instant wake from the sleep, minimum 8 hours of battery life in real life use, Wi-Fi 6 and Thunderbolt 4 connectivity, some form of biometrics and many more. This laptop isn't cheap either. Depending on its SKU, you can end up paying over $2,000 for this bad boy. X1 Nano isn't replacing Carbon, but rather offers smaller and lighter alternative. Thanks to magnesium alloy chassis with carbon fiber casing, Nano feels sturdy and well-built while being very light and portable. Of course, ThinkPads are famous for their military-grade durability, and Nano is no exception. There are times when I need to remind myself that I'm actually holding full-fledged laptop and not just empty chassis. That's how light this laptop feels. There are no bends or odd squeaks. X1 Nano is available in this black finish, or you can also get a carbon fiber weave finish on top cover, but that is only available on touch supported models. One thing that I have to mention is that coating is a pure fingerprint magnet. As you can see, it is nearly impossible to keep this laptop clean and smudge free. Besides paperwork, we can find this very compact 65-watt USB Type-C charger in the box, which I actually like a lot. There are many similarities between 9th generation of Carbon and this first generation of Nano. One of them is return of 16:10 aspect ratio, which offers more of that vertical space. You can appreciate this aspect ratio while using productivity apps where you can get those extra lines and rows. Nano features 13-inch 2K panel with or without touch. Both of these options also have 450 nits of brightness and 100% of sRGB. In case, for some unknown reason, you will decide to use this tiny screen for video or photo editing on the go. Bezels are fairly small, but not as small as we would like to see in 2021. Dell XPS sets a nice example here. Top bezel houses 720p webcam with physical privacy shutter and AR block for that sweet Windows Hello with zero touch login and human presence detection, which is a great feature if you forgot to lock your laptop before walking away from it. There's also a good old fingerprint reader as another way of fast and secure login. From our testing, it's fast, reliable and works great. Now let's talk about elephant in the room. ThinkPads are of course famous for having a brilliant keyboard, and because of how thin X1 Nano is, travel distance has been decreased a bit, 1.35mm instead of usual 1.5, which sounds like a lot, but this keyboard still feels pretty good and has a great tactile feedback. I'm not saying it's not noticeable, but it's still very comfortable to type on. Of course, we cannot forget to mention that this keyboard, just like on most ThinkPads, is spill resistant, so thumbs up there. Function and control keys are in the odd order, which is typical for ThinkPads, but you can quickly swap them around in Lenovo Vantage software or in the BIOS. Oh yeah, that red nipple is still here for those OG ThinkPad users. Trackpad is rather small, but it is plenty responsive, so no complaints there. Speakers, well, they are here, but they're not great. We have two front-facing tweakers and two down-firing woofers with Dolby Atmos. But we have to say that MacBook Air offers way better sound. We have noticed some audio distortion on higher volumes, therefore we would recommend using headphones for your Zoom meetings. Sadly, no USB-A here, but for many, two Thunderbolts 4 ports with power delivery will be enough. Little complaint regarding the port location. They're all on the left side, while on the right, there's only an exhaust vent, which means that while using a mouse, you will feel that hot air blowing on your hand, which could be a little annoying at times. There's also an audio combo jack. This unit is equipped with i5-1130G7 with an Iris Xe graphics, and it's speedy but soldered 16 gigs of LPDDR4X RAM. You can spec out X1 Nano with up to 1 TB of PCIe SSD. In PC Mark 10, X1 Nano scores 4,298. In Cinebench R23, rather poorly. CPU multiscore at 4,227 and CPU single score at 1,279. In Geekbench 5, X1 Nano did not perform shockingly good, and OpenCL results are also poor, but that's to be expected with Iris Xe in such a thin body. So, synthetic benchmarks give us a good idea how does this specific configuration compares to other systems. But how is it to actually use X1 Nano on a daily basis? This laptop can definitely handle some intensive workloads and can deal with multitasking without breaking a sweat. But because of its lower TDP CPU, it might struggle with more demanding tasks. So I would not recommend any video editing here. Lenovo uses intelligent cooling to adjust fan speeds based on your workload. But if you manually change power mode to the best performance, fans will kick on and will stay on for most of the time, which can be annoying during video conference meetings, despite Nano only having one fan inside. X1 Nano has 48 watt hour battery, which is not bad for device this thin. For battery life test, I've decided to play FHD video of the USB-C drive on 50% of brightness and Wi-Fi off. Laptop lasted for something over 11 hours, which is not bad at all. In real life though, based on my testing, you should be able to get through your workday without need for charging. So is new ThinkPad X1 Nano better than M1 MacBook Air? First, Nano supports 5G LTE or 4G LTE connection. Great for mobility or for those whose home internet connection just isn't fast enough. Intel 11th Gen CPU means Thunderbolt 4, while Macs are currently stuck at Thunderbolt 3, which means that you can connect 2 4K or 1 8K display while also getting those sweet 32 gigs per second data transfer speed. ThinkPad keyboards are great, and Nano is no exception. After the disaster with butterfly keyboards, MacBooks went back to Magic Keyboard with a more traditional scissor switch mechanism. Definitely an improvement from Apple, but Nano has a clear advantage here. X1 Nano is 1 pound lighter than M1 MacBook Pro, which is a lot if you work on the go. This one is a weird one, but yeah, the screen opens 160 degrees for quick content sharing if that's what you need to do. Of course, there is more to this, including which OS you prefer to work on. Now we are on 9th generation of X1 Carbon, while X1 Nano is brand new to the family. X1 Nano is stunning, but it has its flaws. Therefore, I would still pick Carbon over Nano, because as addition to everything I just mentioned, you will get slightly higher TDP CPU, 2x USB-A ports, HDMI 2.0 port, 14-inch panel, which is also 16x10, better audio, slightly brighter screen, up to 32 gigs of RAM instead of 16, and of course, larger battery. Okay, so considering everything we just mentioned, here are some main takeaways. X1 Nano is a great laptop, no doubt there. It is portable and powerful, it has some useful AI features, great keyboard, and 2K 16x10 panel, which makes using this 13-inch as your main monitor actually usable for most workflows. Keyboard is still amazing despite decreased travel distance, and trackpad is excellent. If only Lenovo could get rid of those physical buttons in order to make trackpad slightly larger. So there you have it. Not a typical ThinkPad with plenty of ports, but rather modern 2021 representation with great durability and thoughtfulness, really nice display and great keyboard. It certainly has a lot going for. Well folks, that's it for this video. Let us know what would you like us to review next. Make sure to subscribe, thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next one. Thank you.